All right. Okay, this is Real Talk with Beckie and Angie. For this week, it's just Beckie. Angie is working on a top secret thing. It's going to be so exciting. I can't wait to share. She's going to get to share. And then we can talk about it and get it out there in the open. So make sure you watch us regularly because it's going to be really, really exciting. Okay, I'm coming in today by myself because I'm talking about forgiveness. Now, maybe there's no one in your life that you need to forgive. Maybe there's nobody or nothing that you've ever had happen to you to where you need to forgive. By the slim chance that there is someone that you want to forgive or something that you want to forgive, I have got the tool for you. Hey everyone, this is Beckie.
And I'm Angie.
And welcome to Real Talk with Beckie and Angie. I'm going to share a story with you and then I'm going to share the tool. It's going to make more sense once I share the story. Have you ever had somebody just say to you, oh, just get over it. Just get over it. Somebody's done something to you and you're like, just get over it. Doesn't work for me. I remember I had my second husband. Yes, I'm on my third marriage. My second husband, he left me for another woman, like flat out left me, dumped me. And my mom said to me, oh, just forget that jerk. Just get over him. Well, it doesn't work that way. I wish it did. And if it did, by golly, I think we all would be better off if we could just say, oh, just forgive, forget, just forget, just let it go. Well, it's not always that easy. I'm going to share a story with you and then I'm going to share my tool. This tool, I use it with my clients. I use it for myself. I hope that you find value in it and I would love to hear how you use it and how effective it is for you. About, I'd say not quite a year ago, I bought a program, a digital program from someone online that I had done business with before. Been working with this person for a few years, had bought a few programs from this person, and I've been very, very happy with the product, the quality, the support, the interaction. This person has always been a lovely, compassionate, kind human being. When the offer came up about a year ago to buy this product, it was pricey, very, very, very pricey. And I chose to purchase it. Going into it, there was a guarantee. It was very clearly laid out what they were going to do for me and what I was supposed to do. So I, you know, got to provide the information and then they were going to put it into a sales funnel. For those of you that don't know what a sales funnel is, it's basically creating a website, the thank you page and all that kind of stuff. And it was, they said by 12 weeks, within 12 weeks, we can like quadruple your income. Okay. And they guaranteed it. They're like, yeah, this is going to happen. So I'm like, great. I totally trusted this person. I mean, like really trusted them. I signed up, I did it, and I gave all the information that I needed in a timely manner. They did it. They would give me assignments. You know, you need to do this part. And there was a due date. Well, I was always giving the information before the due date. So I'm queuing this up for just wait. So I was always giving the information in a timely manner. 12 weeks in, my sales funnel was not complete, not even close to being complete. They completely dropped the ball. Now, I will say that I chose not to be the squeaky wheel. I didn't get in their face and say, hey, you know, what's happening here? What's going on? Why is my sales funnel not ready yet? Time went by. Well, I checked in because I was working with her team. And then I actually checked in with her and said, hey, you know, my sales funnel's not ready yet. She was surprised to hear that and had no idea. There were some other little hiccups here and there, like by little, I'm not even going to go into the details. There were some hiccups. We'll say that. So I mean, basically, I got the shaft. Lots of time went by. They finally completed it. And it took like, I don't know, like 20 weeks, 20 or 24 weeks to make a sales funnel, which really somebody knowing what they're doing could do this in like 24 hours. It's not rocket science. It's not rocket science. It's ridiculous that it didn't get done more quickly. When it finally got done, I decided to kind of switch gears. I wasn't even going to be selling that product anymore. So I stepped away. I chose to step away. I'm going to say that. About a couple of months went by and it just started sitting at me like, you know, I paid a lot of money and I didn't get what I wanted, what I was promised even. I sent her a message and said, you know, I'm wondering if I can get your support. I've switched gears. I'm wanting to sell a different digital product. Can you help me? And she said, absolutely, yes. To quote her, she said, you really got the shaft and I want to make good on it. Okay. All right. Fantastic. This is good. This is good news, right? Wonderful. And so she made a couple of offers and said, you know, what about this? What about that? And I was like, well, tell me a little bit more. Hey, can we hop on a call and talk about this? And crickets. And another week went by and I said, hey, I'm still here wondering if we can hop on a call or connect or somehow, some way make good on this. Crickets, crickets. So a couple of months went by. I sat on it and stewed on it. I can't even say I sat on it. I stewed on it. It was eating away at me. I'm like, okay, so I got the shaft the first time around. Now I'm getting the shaft the second time around. So a couple of months go by and I'm like, I can't just let this go. I can't just let this go. I get to stand up for myself. I get to say, hey, you know, I got the shaft twice. Are you kidding me? Like, are you kidding me? I sent her a message and I said, you know, I need to share how I feel. And I feel like I've gotten the shaft twice, like kicked in the face twice. Her reply was that the way she sees it is that there was an agreement made and that I didn't keep up my end of the deal. And therefore, it is like a done deal. And if I want to communicate with her, then I can email her. Don't use that method, that system to contact her. Yeah, so that happened. Got the shaft, yet that wasn't even the shaft. That was just a kick in the teeth. So my reply was, that was it. So at that point, I realized that per the agreement, there's no guarantee for money back. So I'm not going to ask for my money back. That's not even a possible. Do I want to, you know, take screenshots of our conversation and say, well, you said you would help me with this. How much did I want to invest in it? How far did I want to go? Did I really want to get in there and be right? Did I really want to get in there and say, hey, you know, you owe me? Or am I ready to let it go? Because clearly the relationship is toast. I don't want to work with her. I don't want to work with somebody who thinks I'm in the wrong when I'm getting the shaft. So what do I do? What do I do? Now, this tool that I'm about to share with you came to mind. I was reminded of it because I was waking up in the middle of the night and I was thinking about her and the interaction. And then recently, I'm like, you know, I notice I haven't seen her on social media. We were friends on Facebook and we followed each other on Instagram. She unfriended me and she blocked me on both social medias. I'm like, I haven't said boo to anybody or anything. I'm not the kind of person that would slander somebody. I'm not going to go on any page and give a bad review. I'm certainly not going to tag her in a post saying this person is a ripoff. And I feel like I know her well enough for her to know that that's not my style. So now I feel like my character has been like another punch in the stomach. So now I have this. What do I do with this? I have anger. I have resentment. I have disappointment. I considered her kind of like a friend. Now what do I do with that? Okay, just let it go, right? Wrong. I am not able to just let it go. So I have a tool that I'm about to share with you. And before I share this with you, if you're still listening, I kind of feel like we're friends now. And if we're friends, please subscribe to us and make sure you like this and share with your friends. Okay, so here's the tool. I'm going to say what it's called. And before I say what it's called, I want to say that you've probably heard of this before. This one is different. Okay, this one is different. This is a forgiveness letter, and there are three components to it. Three, not just one, not the one where you just write to your heart's content until you get it all out on a piece of paper. And then you're like, yeah, it's gone. I'm done. I'm over with it. No, that's not what this is about. Kind of. There's more. There's three components. Okay. You're going to want to grab a pen and a paper so that you can write these down in case you want to do your own forgiveness letter. And also, I'll put a link information down below so that you can request an actual letter of forgiveness. So I use this format with my clients. And I have to say that when we do it in group, or even when we do it on Zoom, it has been so powerful. And I've had some people come back and do it again. And I even had one client, she did a forgiveness letter for a person. I don't even know who it was for. She never shared because it's none of my business. Afterwards, you could tell she wasn't done. And so the next time we met, she did another one to the same person. It's really important that I share that with you because some people, not you, I'm sure it's not you. Some people, they believe that they are an all or nothing person. And so they believe that they need to put it all out there. And if they don't put it all out there, then they've done it wrong. So if you put out there all of it, or so you believe it was all of it, and then later on, you feel like there's a little residual resentment, anger, then you get to do it again. And that's okay. It's okay to do it again. It's not a one-hit wonder here. So I will preface it with that. I don't think I've ever done two for the same person, yet other people have. So you get to do it however you want. Okay, so by now you've got a pen and you've got a paper. The first part of this is you want to put their name on it. You want to actually write out their name. And key, it's key. This gets to be handwritten. Do not type it. There is something about having it in your body and then coming out your hand and going onto paper that is cathartic and it's actually releasing. Typing it, there's a barrier and you're not actually getting rid of it. I know I get to talk with my hands when I'm not in the studio with Angie. Not that it bothers her or anything. It's just, I'm here by myself. So I'm talking with my hands. All right. So you've put their name on it, dear, whatever, or just put their name or hey, boom, and their name. The first part is I forgive you for, and write it all out. In this case, I forgive you for selling me a product that you didn't keep up your end of the bargain. I forgive you for not getting back to me. I forgive you for, basically giving me the shaft three times and then blocking me on social media. I forgive you for get it out there. Write until you feel like it's not in there anymore. Okay, the second part. And when I say this, I can't imagine anyone who doesn't give me this look. They recoil. Okay, so if you're going to prepare yourself to recoil, okay, this is part two. One quality I see in you is, now, no matter what they did to you, I get it. They did horrible things to you or a horrible something to you. And you're like, how could I possibly see something quality in them? One thing, that's it, just one thing. So I found this person has beautiful hair. She has lovely hair. So I wrote, you have beautiful hair. Doesn't have to be a book, just one thing. The one quality I see in you is. Then the third part, this kind of tends to get a little bit of a recoil too. I forgive myself for allowing. This is a really important part because in this scenario that I told you, and there's a reason I told you this story so I could set up for the three components of the forgiveness letter. I get to forgive myself for allowing so much time to go by. I get to forgive myself for allowing it to bother me. I get to forgive myself for choosing to buy this product. Remember, nobody said, Beckie, you got to buy this. I allowed myself to buy this. Okay. So I get to own my part in this. And when you, when you were a little kid, you're pointing your finger at somebody else and they said, you're pointing your finger at somebody and yet you've got three fingers pointing back at you. So you get to own your part in it. And that's really important to write that out. And I also want to say that a forgiveness letter is not for the other person. It is not. This has nothing to do with them. This forgiveness letter is for you. It's a gift that you give yourself. When you're done with this, and there's still more to do with it, so I'm not done yet. So don't be leaving my podcast yet. Stay here. Stay with me. When you do the final step, remember that this is for you. It's not for them. So now you've gone through the three components. I forgive you for, one quality I see in you is, and I forgive myself for allowing. Now you've got your paper However that looks for you, perhaps you've printed this or you've used your own. Doesn't matter. Now you get to burn it. And when I say burn it, I want you to burn it responsibly. Don't go outside and burn it when it's a windy day and you've got stuff going everywhere. Be responsible. If you can burn it in your fireplace, that's the best case scenario. If you don't have a fireplace, get a glass bowl or a metal bowl or something, or even burn it in a sink if your sink is fireproof. You're responsible. Be responsible here. Remember, this is on you, not on me. I'm asking you to be responsible with burning of this. As you watch it burn, you're going to say, I forgive you. I forgive you. I forgive you. The whole time it's burning, I forgive you. I forgive you. And when there's nothing left, if you still feel like you got some I forgive yous in there, let them out. And when you're done, take a deep breath and just let it go. That's how you let it go. That's how I forgive. And that's how I've, my clients, given them the opportunity to forgive as well. I would love to hear how this worked for you. Let me be clear. I'm not wanting to know what you were forgiving, who you were forgiving. I don't want to know the details. It's none of my business. And it's just between you and your paper. What I'd like to hear is, was this effective for you? Did it help you? Go and do it and come back. Next week, we're going to be back in the studio and it's going to be with Beckie and Angie. So thank you for joining me today for Real Talk with Beckie and Angie. See you next time.